Hello there. Welcome to the Freeman Conversations. I'm Joberth Oka. The Games and Amusements Board has suspended the Mindanao leg of the Pilipinas VisMin Super Cup after a controversial game between the Sikihor Mystiques and the ARQ Builders Lapu-Lapu Heroes on April 14. Joining us in today's conversation atong isgutaning controversy sa Super Cup is the ambassador of the Pilipinas VisMin Super Cup, Cebu City Councilor Dondon. Sir, salamat for joining us. Welcome back to the Freeman Conversations. Kumusta?
Robert, kumusta? Thank you for having me. The last time that I was your guest was, I think, before the election, if I'm right, or we did something after.
Kuan, murag, if I remember correctly, this ang last na tong storya katong Kobe Bryant.
Oh yeah. Oh, diha sa Freeman, exactly. Oh.
Yes,
oh,
yes.
Sakto.
Before the pandemic. Pero ang atong isugutan ron medyo controversial, no? This is quite a disappointing development for many, not only the participants of the Super Cup but also sa mga fans. Games and Amusements Board has suspended the Mindanao leg, which was supposed to begin on May 20 with 8 contending teams. And they're also conducting an investigation into the allegations. Nga akong i-quote ang article sa ato ang sports editor sa Freeman, na si Manny Villaruel. The highly controversial match was marred by unbelievable misses such as airballed free throws, botched fast break attempts, and mind-boggling turnovers. What are your thoughts on this, sir? Kumusta? Have you spoken to the teams or any of the organizers so far? What do we know about the investigation being conducted?
Can I go further from the first time that I read about it or heard about it?
Yeah, sure. No problem.
Okay. So April 14, there was this big event here, Quincentennial. So I had no idea what happened. So the kind of activities, and also it was the birthday of my mother. Happy birthday, ma, belated. So when I got home and nakadawat ko text from Olsen Rosella, who is a good friend, and yung message was, "Don, ano na nangyari sa VisMin Cup?" And 3 days prior to that, when I watched the game, naamay gamay nga burag, I would say, Bisaya nga commentator ba? Nga, in a way na ay gamay nga mga, I would say, how do you say, feedback ba? So, mga kong gingon, is it because of the commentator siya? No, something like this happened. So, I checked on social media and dito na ko nakitaan ang free throws and ang miss layup. IG account ni Hope Junkie, which I followed in Instagram. So ako, my initial reaction was nasuko gigo kay dili man mao among gusto mahitabo. I called Attorney John, ako ang abogado, and ko Attorney John, this is not what we talked with the organizer this meet, and na post naman sa ni Kaysen and ni Manny, kay I was receiving from that time nga nakadawat ko text ni Olsen, daghan kay ni message nako nga cons ka nang ikaw ang commissioner, pero bakit inalaw mo tong ganito mangyari? Inana ba daghan kayo and a friend si Marco Alcaraz even post sa iyang IG story, cons unsa man again they're thinking that I'm the commissioner. Ako pang giingnan si Marco in kubay palihog lang tangtang na ako post sa post ni kubay, hindi mo commissioner, but I'll investigate on it, parang ganun. Inana ba? So what I did, I called Attorney John, then I called Rocky. And naay ko andito nga ilang gerason power outage brag na paong ang suga mao na nga gi-cancel ang first half. Then I talked to Rocky Chan, operating officer, chief operating officer na niingon ba nga wi kana among gihunong ang game kay pati na kayo. Then niingon din ko nga Rock kining naa sa gyoy sayo ang ARQ. Kay nganong nagpadaman sila, inana ba? Ito, yes, mo na mong giingon. Kay being a professional, you have to play your best. Inana, I remember during the opening line, I was asked to give a message, niingon jud ko to the players na I'm praying, I'm hoping that you'll be able to represent your city, your LGU, to the best of your abilities. So, ipakita gyud na ninyo, though, in the first few games, makita gyud nato kinsa ang na-excel because they have been together. Ako ngayon, ang kaning Talisay team, kay dito man lang sa Manila, nag-bubble training na sila. They've been together for, advance sila for a month, inana ba? So, pag-abot nila dito, nag-bubble na saan sila. So, continuous ilang kwan ba? Ilang practices. Kita na ko, the first few games na uban nga, ubos, na uban sa taas. But again, when that happened, inquiry, I talked to one of the players na akong former teammate, si Ping Examiniano, that night. Ako siyang ipota na, maayo sa ilaha si Coach Mike Reyes, nindudlo sa ilaha ng mga values. And ang conversation namo ni Rocky is you have to investigate right away. Dili nakapahuwat og dugay, nana ba? And that night, there's an ongoing investigation along with Gab. Kay naamang yung dili nindot ba? Nga gibuhat. And people nga naagid say ma-suspend or unsa mga players that time sa ARQ. With regards to the other team, it's just unfortunate bang something like that happened. Okay, it's not what we envisioned. Nga some meeting supposedly Jobert, it was here in Cebu City, but that time nga among nang mag-start na dire, kay nitaas naman ang cases. So there's a suggestion from Coach Caro nga adto sa Alcantara, and maayo kay ang pagdawat ni Mayor Fritz. In fact, we had a meeting with Mayor Governor Gwen. And pag-abot na mo dito ni Governor Gwen, iyang gipakita sa IATF, mao iyang gipangayo before she will give the blessing sa VisMin Cup. So again, tedious kay ang process ba? And again, the main reason is dagan mga nawag-trabaho, opportunity ani nila nga ma-professional sila nga naay sports tourism sa Alcantara. So, Jobert, neighboring hotels, resorts sa municipalities around generate good income. And that's the main reason I wanted it to be in the city. Kaya ang hotel, mga van, daghan-daghan trabaho ba, mga hatagan ba? But then again, that time, taas the case. So going back, sorry ha, taas kaya akong story leading to that incident. So the unfortunate thing happened. In a way, yes, daghang kay ingon nga dili na maayo nga liga because the league is intended for that kind of thing. I beg to disagree. Yes, I would say na ay pagkuwang tingali sa mga organizers on checking the teams. Kay ang ilaha, the teams, I mean the organizer, dawat sila kinsa interested. Capable ba sila of sustaining this team for 2-3 months, considering na 1 month for Visayas, another month for Mindanao? So, swilduhan nila. Inana ba? Of course, kung ma-out na, wala na sila swildo. Inana, for the duration of the conference sa Manilang contract. But, willing ba sila na? If the teams were willing, as what I have understand from Rocky, so, ilang baton. And sorry lang sa I have friends like si Leody, he posted it nga nagpauaw lang sa secure. Honestly, it's unfair for those guys nga nindot kay imong intention, ganahan ka makatrabaho ako ba players, ganahan ka ma-expose ang mga players nga kuwang pa o dili pa makita ilang abilidad ba, but having this opportunity nga makita sila, there are sponsors, and sa mga sponsors, wala ko i-appeal na Joberta, just to be clear. It's negotiation between officers for the people from VisMin. Initially, I was being offered commissioner, pero considering nga na ako ay trabaho sa Dilisa City, and I have ongoing negotiation also that time with Phoenix, so it will be conflict of interest. So nakasabot sila, so niingon lang sila doon, can you promote the league in a way na you'll talk to the players, you'll talk to the mga team owners, prospect that time. So ako itong gibuhat, being ambassador and also a product of a community-based league, 1998, di ba? So ako, ganahan ko nga na as a player from the South or even from other province nga mapakita ang abilidad ba? So mao gito ang intention. And again, that thing happened, but okay, unsa may nahitabo within the week na ay resolution, I guess, from Congress nga I'm not sure if it was passed already, 220-0 votes nga ma na ay ban, na ay fine for if makita nila nga na ay into, I would say, I would use the word game fixing. Ina na ba kay mauna mo ginila yung pagawa. That thing happened, ako maingon is maayo na lang naitabo this early.
Correct.
And in the playoffs, which daghan na jud kay hindi maayo ba. So what I did last night, ni schedule jud ko og Zoom meeting and I explained being an ambassador that the players are as well maugid ang main product. You have to really perform. How you perform, how you conduct yourselves on and off the court will reflect on the league. So if you're thinking of something kanang dili maayo, the people nga nagtinarong, think of the kanang mga ball boys, think of the referees or table officials or even your team owner. The first thing, your team owner nga nigastong gid para ninyo nya inyo lang, I don't want to use the word baboy, pero kanang inyo lang kanang daoton ba for selfish I would say motives, then but you don't have to be wala kay part sa liga. I mean, it's daghang kay ni trabaho para ninyo, kunya sayang-sayangan lang. So ako yung emphasize sa mga players gabi nga kamo ang product, kamo may mo represent sa league, inyong city and team, and maori kita, and it's the only way to do that is to give your best every time.
Thank you for sharing updates on that, sir. Okay, as someone who is a longtime sportsman and who has also helped organize sports activities and tournaments, ato ba ning gina-anticipate ng mga possible incidents, Sir Dondon?
I think like that, wala na mo yung expect. What we're anticipating is ang kanang the remaining dates nga mahimo niyag non-bearing ba? Eh, kung non-bearing man good, people won't pay attention, maingon na sila, decided naman kay number one ni kaninga team, kay number six ni kaninga team, so most likely, dili na naman ninood. And I'm stating an example like we had when I played for the national team 2015 sa FIBA Asia, na may gisundan ato nga path ni Coach Tab, the coaches, nga the only way to make it to the finals is to avoid China in the semis. So pagkita na mo sa ranking, nga kaninga duwa a maoginisya inana and we did that na kalikay mi sa China sa semis because among gipreparahan ang usa ka team. So nalikayan na mo China, we made it to the finals. Now among gilikayan diri is kanang mga non-bearing games kay naa niya ubang team nga out naman siya. So likely dili na na siya mo go hard and it would be unfair to the team, to the other team na ba. So among gibuhat nga bisag ika ubos pa ka nga ranking or unsa, napakay chance of a tiebreaker or playoff considering ang kaning number 1 and 2 ma waiting na sila sa semis. But that is wa ginanamo gi anticipate kay thinking these players who've been out for more than a year, why would you think something like that?
Yeah,
di ba ana kay trabaho, makaduwa na ka, matabangan ni mo pamilya. Now, if you're thinking about something else, no, not, that's just inana ba? So, ako being, I would say, play basketball to the purest of intention, di ba? Muduwa, magay kag bahala, kag kapoy na karun sa for the love of the game. So, ang amo rang anticipate or ang kuan is malikayan ang kanang mga non-bearing games.
Sir, our sports editor, si Manny Villar, there should be a deeper investigation into the incident?
Well, there should be. Okay. Investigation. I mean, from both teams, even from the teams competing, nga ongoing ginasya investigation. It won't stop until we find ba that case ba nganong naabot na siya dere. And also, though Gab has made a statement, and also it serves as a warning also sa mga teams nga naa sa Mindanao leg. I mean, if na ongoing investigation, the more ba nga they're doing purpose of promoting the city, the LGU, the team, and also opportunities for the players. Dili na lang ang kanang lain nga butang ba?
Right. That's why, perhaps that's the reason why medyo disappointing ang hitabo, no? Okay, this would have been already an opportunity, not just for the players to go back to the game. Murag daghan kay athletes na ito nga na suspend ang action because of the pandemic, but also, as you have mentioned earlier, livelihood, at least opportunity on that to, not only for the players and even the organizers, but the other people involved in staging the games. By the way, katong sa mga wala na kaibaw, no, ang management sa VisMin Super Cup, led by, of course, the COO, Mr. Rocky Chan, has already expelled the entire Sikihor Mystics team immediately after the incident. Lessons from that, sir, from your end, being the ambassador. You mentioned earlier nga team sa Mindanao leg, what would have been a Mindanao leg, no? This would already be a lesson for them to take note of. But from your end, as someone who organizes tournaments like this one,
well, you have to be thorough, be detailed on really checking on the teams that will be part of it. And I would say, Joberta, I met with Jason Alquisola of ARQ. Nakita na ko yung intention of really trying to win. Kay kapila naman ako siya nakontra before the pandemic. Sila ang nag-champions among gihimong. Nakita na ko gusto gyud siya para sa iyang mga players for his team to win. And I remember in one of the press con, in fact, ilang first press con is, if there is an opportunity for his players to be drafted or makuha sa PBA, the more they'll be happy. Kaya maumong yun ilang main reason. And the same with KCS, kang Boss Ricky, I talked to them. And kasi kay nag-meet pa man may adto, and I don't know what happened sa mga uban teams nga gi-invite, but it's the discretion of Rocky. But again, lessons learned is, before you nimo waton, you have to be really thorough, kanang i-check yun ninyo kung capable ba yun. And also background of the coaches of the players. I guess it would be unfair kung naabay ilang previous na itabo, may nanang a case, we cannot prove that. But again, mawa manggod ni tanan, kay there's no basketball for more than a year, and the players nga naanad og panalay nga they will travel to, I would say they would travel 2 to 3 hours, na mudua anang usa ka gibiuna, matalayan sila 1,000, 2,000 pesos, muuli na sad sila sa ilang balay, inana ba nga pag-player ba? At least should be, ha? Pero naanad na sila mga inana ba? And mauna among gibuhat, nga gihimong professionalize, and of course with guidance and kuan sa gab, nga unta mga players makasabot nga they're professional now, they have to treat it nga naagin sila yung responsibility. Professional naagin sila. And that's what I did. I talked to some of the players, to most of the players last night. So, daghang nakatunan lesson. And again, akong maingon na good is, if there's good that came out sa situation ng itabo, it's good that it came out early. Kay naay resolution sa Congress, inakita nung sa pagkuwang sa mga organizers, and nakita sa mga teams from Mindanao that you don't join the team for the main purpose of doing things like that nga, dili pure basketball ba. If the teams went there to give opportunities sa ilang players, mailan ilang LGU, then mao na itong purpose, kaya mao managin na ang main intention. And ang sponsors, mo do all man na if kibaw sila unsa imong intention.
Speaking of sponsors, sir, ang title sponsor sa VisMin Super Cup, ang Chugbo, no? Its president, Mr. Ronald Mascarenhas, is hoping for the Games and Amusements Board to reconsider the suspension of the Mindanao leg. What's your opinion on this?
Well, ang makaingon ako as I would say a basketball, we want to watch games in Anaba. Grateful yuko sa iyang gihatag na support sa liga and supported siya of the decision sa VisMin. But of course, nihangyo siya if pwede. I guess, makaingon sa ko ba nga ganahan lang yun ipadayon sa gud ni Sir Ronald play livelihood for other people ba. So, maosan na iyang gitan now, then, I don't know, hopefully Gab will reconsider it, but as I was saying, akong giingnan, akong gihatag ang responsibility sa mga players karon sa VisMin ba, I mean sa Visayas leg ba. How you conduct yourselves, how you perform, will determine sa mapadayon ba ang liga or ang leg sa Mindanao. So, it's your responsibility. So if you're thinking kanang musud mo na nga butang, think of the people that are excited to play. Think of those mga ball boys. Think of those people that would benefit a lot if maka-perform or maayo, if you conduct yourselves really right sa kaninga league, sa kaninga remainder of the game. So ako lang gihatag nila ang responsibility being the ambassador. Yun sila magiging ambassador sa VisMin ang kaning mga players rin nga nasa Visayas League.
Sir, nabatay mga time frame sa investigations that are being conducted at the very least any investigation sa Games and Amusements Board.
Time frame if there's gone wala pa ko but I'm supposed to talk to also not kanang notana pa ko ni Rocky unsa na ang further investigation but two nights ago gi meeting matay niya ang GAB along with the head coaches and managers ba. So para gyud nga mapadayon gyud ni ang liga and also support from all the remaining teams. But with regards to your kanang question kung night time frame wala pa na.
Finally sir, for today, as an ambassador of the VisMin Super Cup, what's your message to the public na medyo na affected po sa nahitabo sa tournament?
Mubash ta or unsa, especially some players came from Cebu, Anaba, and affected. It's really hard. If you're in that situation, I guess, I don't know, it might happen to you. I cannot go into details kung unsa gyud nahitabo between June. I would say, si Rendell made a statement already why he did that. He apologized. It will be a challenge for him to recover considering kanang daghan siya gyud na igo gyud kay abot ng social media with the states inana ba but he apologized. He could have conducted or he could have responded in a professional way, but then again lesson for us, it's natural naman nga mo react ta. Natural naman jud kayo and ako ni huwat lang jud ko before I made a statement the day after on conversation with the persons involved. Of course, nasuspend tong mga kailan ako nga coaches, kailan ako nga players, sila Luzdok, sila Hercules Tangkay, and katong mga tawhan na muduwa mo gina sila, maninguha mo gina sila, nakontra mananako sila. Pero message lang for natural naman gud nga ipadako gid ang issue, which is dako mo gid kayang issue ba, di ba?
Pero passionate ra ba kay ni mga sports
yes.
Fans?
Yes, well that's the good thing and the bad thing, di ba?
Yeah,
thing, you're passionate if nindot kay ka ang praise gid kamayo. Now if you made a mistake, grabe sa kayo ka og kabash or unsa ba, it's natural and it's the players' ability to handle that kind of challenge will determine their unsa sila the next few years in Anaba. So I'm just hoping for the public na what na to ang further investigation and continue to support in a way ba nga you're part of the league. Yes, there are talks nga bismin mani nganong daghan mga Tagalog or unsa. Again, it's the discretion of the sure if pila kabog yun ang homegrown na ana sa ilang bylaws inana ba so pero nakita na to a player like Shane Menina, Roncal, Analos, Shaq Imperial, daghang kay tag mga abilidad din nga players si Laho, also players that na former teammate ako si Ubalde nga napakita niya unsa siya ka leader sa ilang team sa Talisay. So again, it's natural to really react based on our passion kay passionate man jud kay tang mga Cebuano.
Salamat for joining us, Cebu City Councilor Dondon Hontiveros, Ambassador of the Pilipinas VisMin Super Cup. For a closer look at the latest stories, trends, and events, next time here on the Freeman Conversations.